I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making sausage cheese balls with sweet dipping mustard. It's an appetizer sort of thing, a finger food, and I think you'll really enjoy it. So we're going to go over to the stove and get started. Right here I have a double boiler. I've got my water. It's almost boiling. It doesn't have to actually boil. We just need some heat coming through there. And what I'm going to do is use that to melt 1 pound of cheddar cheese. This is shredded. This is kind of the easiest way to go about it. If you buy it in blocks, then you need to cube it up. But shredded, and this is 4 cups worth if you need to know that. Cheddar cheese, sharp cheddar is what I'm using. We'll just put that in the double boiler and let that be working away while we do something else. All I need to do with this in the double boiler is get it melted so that I can combine it with some other ingredients. So there we go. Now over here, I have I've saved the package here. It doesn't matter what brand it is, but this is country sausage. It could be sage flavored, it could be hot sausage, it could be mild, it could be any kind of pork sausage that you want to choose. I've got it here in my skillet, and it's a deep skillet because it may splatter some as I begin to brown it. So the next thing I'm going to do is brown up this sausage, and I want it to be very crumbly because I'm going to be putting this into a mixture that will form balls. And I'll get started on that. What this means is that I'm going to have to continually tend this while it's browning, but it doesn't take very long. So give me a minute or two, and I'll work on getting the sausage browned and getting the cheese melted, and I'll be right back. I've got my sausage crumbled and cooked, and I will tell you that I did drain it on paper towel, and it took, I also wrung it out to get rid of the grease, and it took 6 paper towels to get it to this point. Now it's not completely dry because that would sort of spoil the recipe, but I don't like to have a lot of extra fat in there, so you should drain it and then use some paper towel to soak up some of that extra fat. Over here we have the cheese, which is melted, so you'll expect it to be like this. Now, if you don't have a double boiler, that's fine. You can just melt it over low heat, but you'll have to tend to it and take care of it and make sure it doesn't stick or anything. But you're just wanting to get it so you can mix it in with some other ingredients. So this is going to be nice. Right now, I think I'll just go ahead and put my sausage in with this cheese in order to transport it over to my workspace where I'm going to add the final ingredient. It's very easy because there are only 3 ingredients in this, so I can probably mix this together a little bit or just wait until I have my other ingredient. My spoon is really kind of bending on me. I'll use another spoon over there. So we come over. And what I have here is Bisquick. Here's the box, and this happens to be Heartsmart Bisquick. And you would think, what's Heartsmart about this? Because it's cheddar cheese and sausage. Well, I feel like if you go to that degree of adding fat in, then try to do something to lessen it. Like I said, wring out that sausage, try to get rid of that excess fat. And here, this has just half as much fat as the regular Bisquick. So I don't feel as guilty if I eat a few more of these as I would otherwise. I have 3 cups of this mixture. This is a biscuit mixture. And so these will make little biscuits, but they're gonna be flavored with sausage and cheddar cheese because this goes in next. And I will say, you know, if you don't want to melt that cheddar cheese, if you want to just use the shredded, that would be okay. It's just the consistency is going to be a little bit different on the sausage balls that come out because you'll see those shreds inside it instead of having the cheese permeating the whole sausage ball. So this is about the best I can do in terms of getting it out. A little bit left in there. And I'll just pop it over here.
And get to work with this with a spoon that's a little bit stronger. Actually, if this weren't hot, so hot, I would just dig in with my hands because I'm going to have to use my hands to make the sausage balls anyway. But we can use a spoon to try to get this together a little bit, and then when it is somewhat together, maybe finish it up with our hands. So this is going to take me just a little bit to get it all blended. That's an important part of the process. So maybe I should just go away, blend this up, and come back and show you how to make some sausage balls. So this is what it looks like as you work that dough. And I've pretty much got all of the white Bisquick worked in. And as you work this, you're going to think, I think I'm doing something wrong because it didn't take her long to get hers ready. It does take a little bit of time to work it in, but believe me, it will work in. And you might think, oh, this is really dry. How can we ever expect that to make balls? Well, it's not a problem. If you can make it into a ball, believe me, there's plenty of oil in the cheddar cheese and also in the sausage to make this work nicely. So you want about a 1-inch ball. Just use your hands to make it and just do this rolling action until it looks like you like. And then place it on a cookie sheet or a pan like this that's ready for the oven. You do not need to prepare the pan. It's ungreased. I have a smaller pan here because I think it will make both of these. It's a big recipe, actually. If you want to cut it in half, that would be fine. It would be easy to just take half of each one of the things I've done. But let me get these going. I'm going to fill this, and maybe this one too, and then I will put it in a 450 degree oven. It's a hot oven, so it will take about 10 minutes for them to brown off and be ready to serve. You can serve them warm or you can serve them cool, and we'll serve them with a sweet dipping mustard. My sausage cheese biscuits are done, and I'm going to take them out. This is a little shy of what I had thought it would take. I thought it would take maybe 10 minutes. See how they look? It's been 8 minutes and they're just the way they should look. So I'm bringing those out and putting them on protective pads and turning the oven off. And let's go around here and serve them. This would generally be for a party and it would be served as an appetizer. You're going to just remove these from the pan and arrange them in any way you like on a serving dish. And I like to use clear a lot for serving dishes, so I'm just going to put a few on here to let you get the idea of what they might look like. I'm not touching them right now because they are very hot. You may eat them while they're steaming hot straight out of the oven, or you can eat them after they have cooled down. If they have been refrigerated or frozen, all you have to do is microwave them and they come back up to fresh. So there you go. And what I'm going to do is show you a way that you can serve them with a dip. Dipping mustard is the best. And I prefer a particular brand, which is Herlocher's. And that is not carried in my grocery store right now. So I am just substituting French's honey mustard. So something sweet, I think, is good with this. And I have poured some of that out into a little dish here. This is a berry bowl, clear, kind of nice for serving. And then I would give my guests a plate and they would come along and maybe pick a couple of these. And let me get a spoon for this. Just take a spoon. And they would perhaps spoon some of the mustard on here. And conveniently, I have my daughter Chelsea to do my tasting today. So they're hot. It's okay. See what you think.
Very good.
There you go.